Hi there, how are you doing today? This time, I want to talk about policy-based authorization in ASP.NET Core WebAPI. This is built based on the JWT authentication. I assume you are familiar with the basics around the JWT authentication. Otherwise, please check the video I linked on the right upper corner. If you are looking for role-based authorization, I have another video dedicated for that topic as well. I'll try to put the link on the right upper corner here, and I'll put the link in the descriptions below too. Alright, now let's come back to the topic of policy-based authorization. What is a policy? An authorization policy consists with a name and a list of requirements. It can be applied to authorize attribute. Let's see an example. Here, I'm going to show you how to protect this resource with a policy named at least 18. Of course, we haven't really built the policy yet. If we run the code now, we're going to get an exception. The message for the exception is very clear. The authorization policy named at least 18 was not found. Let's see how can we build it. The first step is to configure it with the authorization service. Here in startup class, we configured the authentication before for JWT authentication to work. Now let's configure the authorization. On addPolicy method, it accepts the policy name and a delegate for policy builder. Again, policy consists with the name and the requirements. To add a requirement into a policy, let's call addRequirements on policy builder. Oh wait, what is a requirement? A requirement is a collection of data parameters that a policy can use to evaluate the current user's principle. We can think it as a property bag. In our case, we want to construct a policy called at least 18. We need the age property. So we're going to create a requirement of age. Let's call it age requirement. It will implement the interface of iAuthorization requirement. Let me create an age property, because that's what we want to evaluate against. I'll add a constructor for ED assignment. Okay, let's add the requirement to the policy that we are creating. In policy at least 18, there is a requirement of age 18. That is good. But we still haven't told the system how to use the requirement. For example, are we going to allow user older than 18 or younger than 18 to access the resource? Things like that. For that, we'll need another essential part, authorization handler. Let's see how to create one. You may already guessed, as usual, we create a class. It will inherit from authorization handler of the requirement that we just built. There's one asynchronous method that we will have to implement from the abstract class. This method will be invoked when the policy needs evaluation. It will then have access to the authorization context as well as the properties set by the requirement. I'll show you the code for some common evaluation. The first one is that we can check if a user have a specific claim or not. For example, here we are checking whether the user has a claim of age. Notice I'm returning task complete immediately if the claim doesn't exist. There's no point for further checking. If the claim is there, we're going to get the value of the claim. I'll try to parse the integer, and when it is succeeded, I'm going to put the value to actual age. Here, I'm returning complete again in case of a failed parsing. Otherwise, let's do the real check. I'm going to compare the age against the one in the requirement. In case of the actual age is larger or equal to the one in the requirement, I'm going to mark the context as successful. This is how you do it. And otherwise, I'll still need to return the complete of task. Once the handler is created, we will need to register it into the injection container. That is everything that is needed for policy-based authorization. To see it in action, I'm going to update the token issuer to put the age onto the claim list. I'm hard-coded it as 18 here just for simplicity. This value could well be coming from database or some other places. Let's set a breakpoint in the authorization handler and see what happens. I'll grab a token from the token endpoint and use it to access the resource that is protected. The breakpoint is hit as expected. Let me step over. Actually, let's check how the claims look like in the watch window. As you can see, the current user has a claim of the age of 18. We got the value from the claim and parsed it correctly. Since 18 is larger than or equal to 18, of course, the policy will then success. I'll let it run and see the result in Postman. It looks like we got a successful response. As we stepped through, I just realized we probably could complete the task once we verify the policy succeeded. Let's do a quick recap. Policy-based authorization requires four parts to work. A requirement or requirements, those are property bags. A policy with a name and one or more requirements in it. Then there's authorization handler that will be triggered when the policy needs to be evaluated. And the last part to apply the policy by using the authorize attribute. Thanks for watching. I wish you enjoyed it. Feel free to comment below. And don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, take care.